color is you? Maybe not.
Okay, yeah. So how does that work?
Okay, there you go.
Thank you.
And my name is Megan, and I'm the other co-president of the drama club.
Before we start the show, there are a few things we want to make you aware of. First, we ask you please turn off all your cell phones, especially for mobile users, as the FCC has sold rights from this line to T-Mobile, so if your phone goes off, it could interfere with the mic system. So we ask that everyone turn their phones on airplane mode.
Secondly, please stay clear in the aisles, as they will have dancers moving through them, so only get out of your seat during scene changes. Also, we'd like to ask you to pause after Act 1 because there will be a brief announcement from a representative for Gifts for Garnet Valley to talk about how their program works and how you can help.
There are a few people we'd like to thank before the show starts, starting off with Ms. Starter, Ms. Thomas, Ms. Cena, Mr. Fosher, Ms. Greco for all their help in our production, as well as Mr. Huber, Mr. Cooner, Mr. Pham, Ms. Sunstead, all the set guys and all the costumes, everyone who's helped us along the way, we couldn't do it without you, so thank you.
And there may be some fog effects used, but they will just be water vapor, so please know that you will not get any allergic reactions from it.
And finally, I'm Annie.
And I'm Megan, and you're watching Disney's High School Musical on stage.
Just a few quick reminders to brush up on your theater etiquette before our performance of Disney's High School Musical on stage. The show is written for the stage, so there may be many things that are a little different from the movie that we all know and love. And we all can't exactly create the movie magic. But don't worry, all your favorite moments will be set up on stage and better than ever. Please be respectful to all actors on and off stage. The cast and crew has worked extremely hard on putting together the best production possible, and we ask for respect. Cheering, clapping, and appropriate laughter is encouraged. Only enter and leave the auditorium during scene changes or intermission. We will be filming the performances, so loud door noises or talking in the back rows will be picked up by the equipment. There will be a video playing during intermission of our dance captains teaching the dance to We're All Together. So just a reminder, or I should say a warning, anyone can be pulled from the stage to dance with us in our finale. So you might want to learn that. Don't take any photos or videos during the performance, especially with the flash, don't do that. The performance will be on YouTube, so you can't see that. There will be snacks and drinks available for purchase during intermission, as well as Kiss the Cast, candy grams, and flowers to send your favorite castmates or characters with a message to accompany them. Please keep food and drink outside of the auditorium. Our custodians don't work extremely hard to keep this place clean. Just like all you guys are already struggling enough with the students, so please try and keep it all out. Actors will be outside in costume immediately following the show to take pictures and greet audience members. However, it's only for a short period of time, so our costume staff has worked extremely hard and should not be made to go home late. After getting out of costume, actors are welcomed and encouraged to talk to friends and family. Please be courteous and do not attempt to distract the pit or crew during the performance. We fully understand that maybe your friends, family, or even your music teachers, but we want to put on the best show possible for everyone that took the time to come out to support GBHS PAA tonight. So mark your calendars for a spring show, Annie, March 7th through 9th, and that's all for now, peeps. Enjoy the production of Annie's High School Musical. Garnet Valley's High School Musical.
Thank you. Yeah.
listen up for the very first morning announcements of the brand new year. This is Jack Scott, the Velvet Fog of Eastside, coming at you with over 411 on what's going down and coming up this week. The Science Decathlon finals will be on Friday, so check out Taylor Learning Curve McKesson for more skinny on the hoodie. During free period, the AV Club will be meeting in room 213, and the Science Club will be meeting in room 312. Then they'll alternate the schedules and reverse one more time to finish out the winter quarter. The Skydiving Club will be meeting on the roof deck at 3 p.m., and the First Aid Club will be waiting for them in the parking lot down below. Catch my drift. All for now, peace.
But soft, when light through yonder window breaks, it is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon, who is already sick and pale with grief, that thou, maid, art far more fair than she. Thank you very much. Once again, they forgot to announce auditions for the winter musicale, Juliet and Romeo, written by our very own Kelsey Nielsen. Kelsey, stand up and take a bow. It's a delicious neo-feminist adaptation of Shakespeare's classic tragedy with three counts of three tap numbers. By thinking outside the box, Kelsey has brilliantly reimagined a tragedy into a happy one, in which the two lovers both live and move to Albuquerque. It's simply bursting with sword fights, meddling parents, and teenagers caught in the grips of forbidden love. Well, if you kids can't relate to that, I'll eat my gum! All right. So, there will be singles auditions for our supporting roles and chorus, as well as pairs auditions for our two leads. Mr. Danforth, this is a place of learning, not a football court. Save your bilabial fricatives for someone of your own primitive aesthetic. Once again, as always, the drama club faces a dearth of male participants. So please come out and audition. I am offering you the chance to spread your wings into bold new horizons. I am offering you the timeless allure of the grease paint, the magical power of the Klieg light. Okay. I'm offering you extra credit. Attention, we have a zero tolerance policy for phones here, so I'm sure we'll be getting to know each other very well in detention, Miss Montez. Welcome to East High. Mr. Bolton, I see your phone is involved as well. Give it. Detention.
That's not even a possibility, Miss Darvis. Your Honor, like, sir, because we have basketball practice after school, and Troy is our captain.
30 minutes for you, Mr. Danforth. Count 'em.
That might be tough for Chad, since he probably can't count that high.
Taylor McKessie. 35
minutes.
But I've never had a detention in my life.
Oh, well then, Happy New Year. This ain't my first time at the rodeo, kiddies. Shall the carnage continue? Saved by the bell. You may collect your phones after detention. Have a wonderful day! Susan, please.
Attention custodian staff. A nauseous freshman just shared his pancakes all over the third floor corridor. We are taking major spewage, so please watch out for me. Sorry, folks. This just it. Please remember to sign up for the school musical, Juliet and Romeo, written by a red-hot composer babe, Kelsey Nielsen. Sorry, folks.
I don't believe
me either.
Yeah. We just moved to Albuquerque. I cannot believe you live here too. I tried to look for you in the lodge on New Year's Day, but
I can't believe we're sleeping.
Why are you whispering?
What? Oh. Well, you see, I told my friends about the snowboarding, but I didn't exactly tell them about the singing.
Too much for them to handle?
It was cool, but my friends, that's not what I do.
Pretty crazy, right? Meeting up again like this?
I was gonna call you, like a bunch of times, and, well...
And?
You know, I,
You chickened out.
Kinda.
Cool.
Now that you're met Darvis the Deranged, I'll bet you can't wait to sign up for the musical.
Oh, I won't be signing up for it. I've been here for a while. I just want to get to know the school, but if you signed up, I'd consider coming to the show.
That's completely impossible.
I wouldn't think impossible is even in your vocabulary, Troy! So nice of you to show our new classmate around. Troy is such a sweetheart, isn't he? He's the star of the basketball team, just like I'm the star of the drama club. Are we having lunch together, Troy? Oh, look, sign us for the musical. Are you going to sign up too? I'm so sure we could find something for you. The ugly old nurse is lots of fun.
No. I was just looking over the bulletin board. Lots going on at the school. Wow, nice penmanship.
I missed you during vacation, Troy. So, what'd you do,
Practice basketball, snowboarding, more basketball. Gotta go, practice it all.
You're so dedicated, just like me. I hope you'll come watch me in the musical. Promise? Maybe it's my hair.
Hey, Wildcats. It's request time again. And this one comes out from Vice Principal Vinny Ichikawa. And to the students of the air out of his tires. Sorry, folks. This just in. Seems we have another request that goes something like this. Troy Bullen, get your butt to practice on the double, or you're grounded for a week. Off now, please.
Girls, you're with us today. Coach didn't show up. All right, now. Remember, the chain is only as strong as its weakest link. And when the going gets tough,
the tough gets going!
I guess you know that one. Now give me 10 minutes of weak drills. And show a little hustle already.
I'm certainly, Coach. So, you know that school musical
thing? Yeah,
pretty cool Darvis giving extra credit just for auditioning, right?
Do you think LeBron James or Shaquille O'Neal ever auditioned for their school musical?
I mean, well, like the extra credit's good for college and all.
Really? You know what's better? A big, fat basketball scholarship. How?
The team captain Bolton, get your head in the game.
Man, that's tough. Alright, line up! Run the shuffle drill. Let's go. Coach said to big right, big left. Watch out for the thing, keep your eye on the fence. Gotta run the give and go, look the part of the hole. Don't be afraid to shoot the outside, Jay. Just keep your head in the game.
Just keep your head in the game.
And don't be afraid to shoot the outside, Jay. Just keep your head in the game. You gotta get your head in the game. Gotta grab and go. Maybe this time we'll hit the right note.
To see her again.
I've got to see her. Wait a minute, I'm the time and place. Wait a minute, get my head in the game. Wait a minute, get my head in the game. Wait a minute, I gotta get my head in the game. up, get my head in the game. Come on, get my head in the game. I gotta get my head in the game. Why am I feeling so wrong?
You have to ask yourself, is your head in the game?
My head's in the game, but my heart's in the song. Yikes.
Ball up, we out, we out, now we gotta swerve up. Now break, make the pass, clean the glass. Take another swipe for the cherry shot. Make a slam dunk, get the inside, outside, dunk it down, dunk it down.
Thank you.
you. Kiss today goodbye. Sorry. And point me towards attention. So all you evil doers better get your butts to the theater immediately or face the wrath of Darvis the Merciless. This is Jack Scott, signing off.
Yes, my brave little detention menagerie. We thespians often use animals to build the characters we play. Be the bear, be the ostrich, be the monkey. Chum, chum, chum now, explore. Ryan, do you want to be an ostrich?
Totally.
Ryan.
Yeah, it's okay. Ostriches are cool, I guess.
For Sharpay, maybe, but what about for you?
For me?
Yes, unless you want to live the rest of your life in the shadow of your sister's ostrich.
The answer is yes.
Huh?
With credentials like these? We'll win for sure. Where did those come from? Didn't you put them in my locker?
Of course not.
Well, we'd love to have you on the team. We meet almost every day after school.
I don't know. I think I need to catch up on the curriculum before I even think about joining any clubs.
But what a perfect way to get caught up! Meaning with the smartest kids in school? What a generous offer, Taylor!
We've never, ever won the decathlon. You can be our answered prayer.
Well, okay, I guess I can do it.
Yay.
Okay, so, quid pro quo, what do you know about Troy Bolton?
I wouldn't consider myself an expert on that particular subspecies. Unless you speak cheerleader, as in, oh my god, it's a Troy Bolton just like the hottest supermodel?
I guess I don't speak cheerleader.
Which is exactly why we exist in a completely alternate universe to Troy the basketball boy.
Have you ever tried to get to know him?
He has his clique, and I have mine. You'll see how it works at lunch when you sit with us.
I mean, you don't think doing the musical could be fun? Like, even a little bit?
You're a hoop student, not a musical singer person.
I wasn't talking about me. No way.
Good, because you can't expect the rest of us to be focused on the game. If you're off somewhere singing, leotards!
Whoa! No one said anything about leotards.
Maybe not yet, my friend. Will you just wait?
You are all doing brilliantly, James. I had no idea an earthworm could have such depth, such pain. Now, let us all gather around into a circle to experience the magic. That is theater. James? Let everyone in now. Scooch. All right. Now this is called the ball of noise. The idea is to pass around an invisible ball while making some kind of sound to accompany it. Once passed, the ball can land in any part of your body. And you're only limited by your own imaginations. Go! Do whatever you feel, Troy. You're only limited by your own imagination. Excellent work.
Jim. Now!
Yay! You've all done one.
and Troy are our two star players. You cannot have them in here acting like idiots when they should be at practice.
They were not acting like idiots. They were acting like actors. If Troy and Chad were theater performers instead of your little sports stars, would you seek preferential treatment for them? I think not.
We are days away from the biggest game of the year.
And we are in the midst of auditions for our winter musicale. This school is about more than young men in baggy shorts flinging balls for those touchdowns.
Baskets. And the Westside Knights have knocked us out of the playoffs for 3 years.
Yes. And despite that consistent track record of defeat, the school still sees fit to allocate 10 times as many funds to sports programs as it does the arts.
Win or lose, it doesn't matter. I'm teaching these kids about something that does, like setting goals and teamwork, something they can actually use as adults.
Which is precisely what I am trying to instill in them.
How? By having them scream at the top of their lungs?
Philistine!
Crackpot!
Another train wreck on school day. The auditions for Juliet and Romeo will be starting tomorrow day again at 3 p.m. sharp. So all you barely pursued dudes that are revved beyond your vocal cords, this is Jack Scott, over and out. In 5, 4, 3, 2...
That was deeply disturbing. Go see a therapist! You truly have. Now, for pairs auditions, we have... Let's check. Only one group signed up. Can you make sure that's right? Just one? Okay. Sharpay and Ryan Evans.
Now, what's your job?
What key?
Hey. Thanks, but we had our rehearsal pianist make an arrangement for us. Volunteers? It's hard to believe that I couldn't see that you were always there beside me. Always there beside me.
This feeling's like no other. I want you to know.
Hard. I can dumb it down for you. Again.
So good to be seen, so good to be heard. Don't have to say a word.
So long it was lost, so good to be found. Love and having you around. This feeling's like no other. I want you to know. I've never had someone who knows me like you do, the way you do.
No way. I came to, give you more support. You're auditioning, right?
No. Your friends don't know you're here, do they?
Right.
You're not afraid, are you?
Me? Afraid? You're the one who's afraid.
I am not afraid.
R2?
I'm not. I'm R2, not, and not, and not. R2?
Really? Then get up there and prove it. Don't be afraid. I'll be right here.
I'd like to audition. service.
I am so sorry, my dear, but timing means everything in the world of theater.
But I'm
not. I called for the individual auditions, and you did not show up. There's no one to audition with you for the lead parts.
I'm so sorry.
Ms. Darvis, I'll audition with her.
Troy Bolton. Where's your sport posse? Whatever it's called.
Team. But I'm here alone. Actually, I'm here to sing with her.
All right, but you must know, I treat these practices just as seriously as your father treats his little basketball recitals. I called for the leads auditions. You weren't there. Yeah, Bluff Jack.
It's Troy. So, you wrote that song Ryan Sharpage sang?
Uh-huh.
And the whole show?
Uh-huh.
How long did that take you?
About 2 years. I get up at 5 every day before school, and I'm still working on the finale.
Wow, you're so dedicated. So, why are you afraid of Sharpay then? It is your show after all.
It is?
Hello, thank you.
Isn't the author of a playwright sort of like the playmaker in basketball?
Playmaker?
You know, the one who makes everyone else look good. Not you? There is no show. You're the playmaker here, Kelsey.
Yeah. You want to hear the way the song's supposed to sound?
What's going on?
speak.
I got news, bad news.
Go ahead and speak.
Gotta pass it around, every honest boy.
What, no way?
That's not our boy.
Pass it around, now don't be slow. Gotta go, gotta tell everybody I know.
They got a callback.
This is a one beat trail I'm gonna sing.
This is a kind of sick joke. Troy and Gabriella didn't even audition.
And they never even asked our permission to join the drama club. I mean, come on.
Someone's gonna change that new world of rules.
Right. What? Are we all set?
Rule number one. Pick the right click. Two. Act like your click. Three. Dress for your click. Four. Know where your click clicks. And rule number five. Stick to the status quo!
Dude, you are so totally awesome. Thanks.
Why?
Well, if you can come out the open about singing, then I can show my singing too. I love to bake.
What?
Yeah, there's nothing but net when I'm in the zone or on a roll. But I got a confession, my secret obsession that's making me lose control.
Everybody gather round.
Scones, strudels, even apple pan down.
call back? I mean, is she really that mad?
Let's put it this way. No one has beaten Sharpay out for a musical since kindergarten.
Troy, because of you, I finally gonna give Sharpay a token of my love. Look!
I don't know if now's the best time to give Sharpay a cake. Stop you from doing what you want to do. You are what you do, right?
You're the big guy. basketball star, you love the spotlight. I'm a lot happier curling up with a good book.
Hiding?
No.
Maybe?
Well, I don't know, maybe. Remember in kindergarten, you meet a kid, know nothing about them, and 10 seconds later you were best friends and didn't have to be anything but yourself?
Yeah.
Singing with you felt like that. Like, safe, you know?
I never thought about singing before, that's for sure. But, when I look at you, I feel like anything's possible.
So you really wanted to do the callbacks? That's cool, I guess I don't want to either.
No, I'm in.
Really?
Hey, just call me Freaky Callback Boy.
You're a cool guy, Troy, but not for the reasons your friends think.
You never know what you're gonna feel. You never see it coming, suddenly it's real.
Oh, it never even crossed my mind that I could ever, ever hope to find someone like you.
Oh, oh, things change when you don't expect them to.
No one knows what the future's gonna do.
Never even noticed that you've been there all along.
I can't take my eyes off of you. I know you feel the same way too. I can't take my eyes off of you. All it took was one look for a dream come true.
Themselves.
So what you're saying is that the individual must be sacrificed for the good of the whole. That's very Karl Marx.
Okay, Troy, in the locker room. You guys nab Gabrielle?
Whatever, just work until he breaks.
Troy Bolin is my best friend. I know how to push all his buttons. Now remember, the line of communication is crucial to this successful deployment of this covert.
That many syllables in one sentence. I'm impressed.
Thanks. Working on it all night. My watch says, 1300 hours Mountain Standard Time, of course.
Save it for Charlie's Angels, Chad. Au revoir, mon ami.
I love it when you speak German.
Danke schön.
choice and show that they've covered the entire student body.
And if the brainiacs get Gabriella hooked up with Troy, then the science club goes from drool to cool. Ryan, we need to save our show from people who don't know the difference between a Tony Ward and Tony Hawk.
But how?
Darvis, I have a plan.
Lucy!
I'll tell Darvis that Troy and his dad want to sabotage the audition because she gave him detention.
She'll never believe that.
She'll believe anything I tell her because I'm the president of the drama club.
The president's not supposed to lie, Sharpay.
Yeah. And the vice president's supposed to smile, sip it, and do what I tell them to do, all right? Now come on!
you're good at hoops, too.
Yeah, I once scored 41 points at a league championship game.
No way.
The same day I invented the PlayStation and the iPod. I've been rehearsing with Kelsey.
I know, me too. And I was late for basketball practice twice now, so if I get kicked off the team, it's on your conscience.
Hey, I didn't mean to...
Gabriella, chill.
Sorry, miss. This is a closed practice.
Dad, practice is over.
Not until the last player leaves the gym. Team rules.
I'm sorry, sir.
Dad, this is Gabriella Montez.
Your detention buddy?
Gabriella, I need you in the lab right away.
Hip hop right. I'll see you later, Troy. Nice to meet you, Coach Bolton.
Detention was my fault, not hers.
You've never missed a practice in 3 years, and then that girl shows up, and you're late twice.
That girl is named Gabriella, and she's very nice.
Making you late for practice doesn't make her very nice in my book, or your team's.
It's nothing. She's just a girl.
But you're not just a guy. What you do not only affects this team, but the entire school. Without you completely focused, we won't win this game Friday. These things are special. They don't come along very often.
A lot of things are special.
If you blow this chance, you'll regret it for the rest of your life.
You mean like you did?
You're a playmaker, Bolton. Not a singer.
You ever think maybe I could be both? And my name is Troy, not Bolton.
Wildcat legends won championships worrying about some brainiac chick auditioning for school musicals?
Do you think these paradigms of education and accomplishment concern themselves with jocks or auditioning for musicals?
I don't think so!
Championship game. Do it for him, Troy. Give him the championship he always dreamed of.
Heartbreak Bolton. Just another lost cause, bonehead. Basketball is Ronnie's job. And you? You're the future of civilization.
Amelia Earhart to Gabriella Montez.
into that game, then you don't know me at all.
Yeah, we're counting on you.
I thought you were my friend. Win together, lose together.
We're counting on you.
I am for the team. I'm always for the team.
So don't let us down.
How about what matters for me?
You gotta come through.
What do you want from me?
Singing means nothing to me. Gabriella means nothing to me. I'll forget her. Forget the callbacks. And we'll go win ourselves another championship game.
Troy. Troy, Bolton.
For you.
Troy.
Gabriella, what's wrong?
Guess what? I don't want to do the callbacks either. Who were we kidding? You've got your team and now I've got my team. Do the science decathlon and you go win your championship. It's where we belong. Go Wildcats.
No, but I don't want
to. Me either. Goodbye.
So, Gabrielle, do you want to grab a Coke? Alright, I'll see you later.
Dude, want to grab some lunch or something?
I made you a foie gras tartlet.
Maybe because I know what I'm doing. Just do what I tell you to do, all right?
I'm not taking any chances, understand? That role is mine. I was born to play it.
Somebody in this room needs to calm down, sister. And it's not me. But get the roles you want. We always do.
I'm not just talking about my role in the play, Ryan. I'm talking about my role in, like, the school. I'm not a jock. I'm not a brainiac. But you know what? I'm the star. That's my role. And if they take that away from me, who am I? Oh, my God.
You could just be Sharpay for once. It's not so bad, is it?
Are you brain dead? No one's going to like me if I'm just Sharpay. But on stage, I can be Juliet. I can be Annie Oakley. I can be anyone I want to be. Not just dumb old Sharpay. I need something to make me fabulous, Ryan. I mean, come on. They named me after a flabby dog.
Sharpay, we've had the roles every year since birth. We get the parts. Great, but if we don't, we'll still be fabulous. And trust me, it could have been way worse. Like, I can't even be like Shih Tzu or Pug or Beater Dog.
Troy, that. Troy, that.
Right now.
Thing!
Yeah, well, maybe Troy would like you more if you dressed yourself.
Pardon me, Dr. Phil, but what do you know? You're just a kid.
I'm only 8 minutes younger than you.
Yeah, well, those are 8 important minutes.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know you guys were in here.
Oh, hi, Troy! Did you come to ask if I'd switch partners and audition with you? The answer is yes! Ryan, you're fired.
Sharpay!
No. Have you seen Gabriella? I need to talk to her.
Who?
Golden Doodle.
Yeah.
Wait, Troy. I saw Gabriella. She was in the practice room, like, 10 minutes ago, maybe?
Thanks, Ryan. You're all right.
How can you stab me in the back like that, helping the enemy?
I stabbed you in the back, Schnauzer. Why did I think about that?
At least you admit it. Now take it from the top and lose those jazz swears.
Tabby!
That's a cat!
Something new.
friends.
Yeah, we have to tell them we're going to do the callbacks after all.
Well, let's move it already! We're burning daylight!
Yeah, me too, I think. I mean, what are we gonna do now?
I don't know.
I don't either. We have something we have to tell you.
No, us first.
No, this is important. Trent and I have decided.
Gabrielle means is that...
Hey, all you crazy wildcats. Just a reminder that the science decathlon and school basketball game championship will both be starting tomorrow afternoon at 2 p.m. So don't be late, baby. Come on out and support you. Sorry, folks. This just in. Seems we have a late-breaking Wildcat newsflash. The callbacks for Juliet and Romeo have been moved up to tomorrow at 3 p.m. But Miss Darvis, you can't. Sorry, Troy. This is Jack Scott. Over and out.
What? How can they do this? It's not fair.
How can you be at the Science Decathlon
and win the championship
and audition for my show?
We can. Well, it's clear you only have one choice.
There's only one thing you can do.
Yeah, we know.
Maybe next year, right? Audition for the musical.
What? But what about the team?
I thought you wanted to win the decathlon. So we come in second. That's no disgrace.
Win or lose, we're teammates. That's what we're about. Even if you turn out to be the worst singer in the world.
Which might be. But I haven't actually heard you sing.
He's fantastic! They both are.
What we did was so wrong. We just want you to know that we'll be there supporting you. In spirit, at least.
Yeah, Cap, if singing is something you want to do, we should be boosting you up, not tearing you down.
It's hard to believe that I couldn't see. You were always there beside me. Good luck in the big game, Troy. So sorry about the callbacks, Gabriella.
So anyway, we've made our decision.
I'll be there for the team, Taylor.
Me too. It's just a musical anyway.
Just a musical?
You know what he means. We can't be selfish. Not when our friends are depending on us, right, Troy?
Right.
But you can't!
But we can. See you guys later. Come on,
Gabrielle. We can't let them do it!
Yeah, a dream deferred and all that.
Right. We have to figure out a way for them to do both.
Team huddle.
Hey, you spoke job.
I'm good at foreign languages, remember?
Down to the split second.
Jack Scott can help us. He's an elder game.
It's impossible.
Leave it to me. I can do anything with my laptop.
Go Wildcats!
Yesterday, we all were on a road. We didn't really know.
Oh!
Zarvis. Good luck at the callbacks today.
Go Drama Club!
Chad Snelling!
Wildcats rule, baby. And now we watch as we see the red-hot Eastside Wildcats take the court, led by team captain, Roy Bolton.
Now, let the callbacks begin!
You will have 2 minutes to solve this equation.
Ready, set, and...
I believe I'm dreaming.
Maybe it's been up one, you've got to raise the bar.
Please, just give us a chance.
Chance for what, Troy?
to make a joke out of something that means the world to me and also your fellow students who came out to audition?
But it's not a joke. I came here because I want to give it my best shot.
Please, we only have a few more minutes until the lights come back on. Full house?
As president of the drama club, I have to put my foot down. No preferential treatment. Those are your words, not mine.
That's my question.
Miss Darvis, Char wasn't trying to throw the auditions. Sharpay lied.
Shut up!
Seven. Is this true?
Did you abuse the presidential privilege and knowingly lie to me?
I didn't lie. I improvise.
A riddle. A riddle.
Talk about this later, Miss Evans. As for right now,
off the stage.
But I...
Off the stage.
Yeah. The stage is all yours, Miss Darvis.
But we don't have a pianist.
We can sing without music.
Oh, no, you won't. Pianist here, Starvis.
You really don't want to do that.
Oh, yes, I really do.
Ready on stage.
Now that is Starvis.
So much easier when it's just you and me.
And just pretend it's you and me. Just like kindergarten, remember?
All that we can be.
Congratulations!
Right.
place.